nope. Mio's like, nah, just kidding. I don't want to be mayor, actually. My noble steed.
The ship doesn't swerve when it sees how big the iceberg is.
I like big plants, and I cannot lie.
And I think I need to go back to... Wait, what?
You ready for some top secret horse-based intel? There's a food that horses just love. It's... carrots.
I think you were supposed to do that! Oh, what?
Sir?
Well, hello, everyone. I was finishing a quick late lunch there since I got my rice done in time. We have rice and a, I think it was an eye of round roast. So basically a roast beef. That's really good. I also have a banana that I will be munching on. I still need to fix the fact that I don't have a just chatting anymore. Here's what we're gonna do. Hello, everyone. How's it going? Well, I would do the hand cam if I had my USB-C, but I do not. Okay, so I don't have my webcam blown up. No, I did that on purpose. I was trying to see if I could move the webcam to the middle, but I'm not gonna be able to do that easily without fighting with it. All right, first things first, I need to figure out how I'm gonna put all of this stuff on screen without making OBS crash. Why didn't the fighter work? Biscuit got it a while ago. Okay. So what happened was the fighter spawned when we were on the starting soon screen, but because the fighter overlay is not on that screen, it didn't show up until we came to this scene. So that's probably why. Because I was like, oh wow, it's supposed to be a 300 second cooldown, and I was like, 171, that's pretty late. That explains it. Yeah, I do wish that there was something I could do to train Mix It Up Bot a little bit better, but alas. So. Yeah, it did show up in chat. Welcome in, everyone. Hi, Bill. You can just leave it there. All right, let me get the early bloomers pins all situated because we have a question mark block. And we have a cheap. And we have to minimize the Kirby. Happy Tuesday, everyone. Yeah, fighter is a rare one, so it's one of the bugs that when you squish it, it dies. My mom had mentioned, though, that she thought maybe changing the color of the text for the rare ones might be a better visual reminder. I do at least have the text set up to say, like, so-and-so destroyed the enemy instead of, like, just stomped the enemy. Pretty sure. Yeah. Anyway, I digress. I am rambly. I am gonna figure out how to put this cool new merch stuff up on screen without OBS crashing and throwing a temper tantrum. We will figure it out. And it might end up just being done through a screenshot, but, you know, that's fine. I hope you guys are having an excellent Tuesday. Come on. Yeah. There we go. Because, yeah, I think what happened last time OBS hard crashed was because I tried to put the picture, like the art picture, in OBS. And for some reason, when you put a PNG in OBS, it tries to actually go pixel by pixel how big it is. So obviously, if you're doing digital art and you have a canvas that's like 12,000 pixels by 12,000 pixels, it's going to try to put that in OBS and it's going to hard crash and you're going to have to reboot everything. We have learned that, actually. So we actually have, we've got so much going on right now. And I'm very excited about it. Let's see. Magi Market is open in Palia. Last I checked, they're actually still in the middle of maintenance, unless they tweeted an update since after my rice got done. But yes, the event should be starting today, and I plan on checking it out tomorrow. Oh, you got a Discord message. That's exciting. All right, who's ready for our first announcement? Where did this save? This is always what happens. Here we go. Drum roll, please. All right, so our first announcement, pardon my awful vocal drum roll. First announcement is we are starting a monthly Ko-fi membership package. And this package is going to come with goodies based around baddies. So for the month of September, what we're doing is, this is an Octoguy from, I think, Super Mario Galaxy? Why does it have the... I can't win. Anyway, there is going to be 4 stickers and a physical pin if you are subscribed to the higher tier. I think it's $4 for the pins and the stickers and the postcard, and $8 if you want to add the pin. So this is my first time attempting to do any sort of like monthly merchandise goodie bag. So as such, I have not physically produced any of the items yet, but I have plenty of sticker paper. I have plenty of printable shrink wrap or printable shrink paper. And I'm super excited to start making these up. This is what the hard copy looks like. And I was thinking about doing a little giveaway for the actual hard copy. Hi Fiona, welcome in! You're just in time for our announcement. We're starting a Ko-fi membership tier. 2 of them, actually. For some monthly goodies. I don't know why it disappeared. I'm gonna see if I can get it to show up, but I'm very afraid. We're gonna try it. I'm gonna hate everything, probably. Yeah, I hate everything. Why are you like this? We're gonna be here for the next 30 minutes while I make this an appropriate size. I'm so glad I didn't try to drop all of them in here at once. So this is your monthly coffee cup design. And that's basically what we're gonna do, is each month there's a new baddie, and we're gonna make a bunch of different goodies around whatever that baddie is. Including a different coffee cup paper wrap, a different cookie, a beans recolor, and then the actual enemy itself, and there will be a physical early bloomer style pin of that enemy. So I'm nervous, but I'm excited, because let me tell you, if I could make a job out of packaging things and like doing stationery and putting labels on things, I would be in heaven. I had a job where for the longest time they had me preparing like film samples, like little sample packs, and I had to put little labels on a bunch of 8x12s that I had to like hand cut. I was in heaven. I didn't even care that I wasn't using my degree because it was so much fun. So anyway, this is my first time trying to do memberships through Ko-fi. We will see how it turns out. This will be the month of September, and then there will be all new designs for October. That was announcement number 1. Are you ready for announcement number 2? Maybe I'll do this as a window. I'm gonna switch the song before I lose my mind in a good way. I love the song, don't get me wrong. Please don't misunderstand. Alright, let's see if I can get this figured out. Are you ready? Announcement number two. We have Pikmin postcards available on the Ko-fi. All five of them. There's five different designs that we have made. A postcard is going to be $3 USD and free shipping. And congratulations, Dennis, on getting first. You win the physical copies. I definitely didn't plan that. You're not gonna complain. So that's announcement number two. Look at all of these designs. We got the little red Pikmin with the strawberries. We have the yellow desert Pikmin. We got a blue fairy blueberry Pikmin. The little rock guy just chilling. And then we have the glow Pikmin, which is the new one from Pikmin 4. So these are all available as 4x6 postcard prints. I will print them myself and then I will mail it to you. Dying for the glow Pikmin. I really like how that one turned out. I really do. The yellow one, I think, is my favorite, though. And we have one more announcement. So you can find those prints on my Ko-fi. I'll probably pin that later. Last announcement. You may have seen this in the Discord already, but guess what? We have an official Souptember shirt. I got approached by someone from World Central Kitchen. All I had done at that point was I made the campaign called Souptember and said I was supporting World Central Kitchen's Chefs for Hawaii. And I got them in my inbox kind of asking me what Souptember was, which I thought was very exciting. And after a little bit of back and forth and kind of like getting to know each other, the one person in my inbox called us superheroes. And we had been kind of brainstorming and trying to figure out what we wanted for like a Souptember merchandise or shirt, like something official. And of course, we could not resist the idea of making a superheroes shirt. So this exists. You can buy it in multiple different fall colors. And if anyone wants a particular color that is not here, please let me know. I can edit and add more colors. Soup! I did say soup. I love how this turned out. I really do. It's been a really, really productive week for art. Can I just say that? It's been such a week for art. So $10 from every t-shirt sale will be donated to the Souptember campaign. I possibly could add that in. We are doing another silent auction this year. I cannot wait to show you what the prize is going to be for said silent auction. It's gonna be great. In the meantime, why don't we get into some Dandori practice? And I think I need to turn my ring light up just a little bit. One second. Last time I had it on, I think my sister said that the light was bright and it bothered her. Which is like, yeah, that's fair. She's not quite used to this. The Pikmin are not part of the soup. Are you sure? Are you absolutely certain about that? I'm pretty sure I'm good, but let's just save and quit to make sure! Game saved. Closed. Is my stream connection okay? You haven't played the Switch since Thursday? I have not. I've been very busy doing, like, a ton of art. Like, I cannot stress enough just how much art I have been doing off stream. I even got myself into the hobby of rubber stamp carving. And so I've got on my Amazon wishlist right now, or I guess my shopping cart right now, a little set of beginner ink pads. Inky pads? Well, he's over on the bed right now. I probably don't want to rub the rubber stamps all over him. Day 5. But yeah, I made a little CGRH stamp, and my goal is to cut all of the letters out individually so that I can color them to actually be like the logo. And who knows, if I like it, maybe we'll switch to that instead of, like, I don't know, sometimes I like digital, but sometimes there's an appeal to doing something with traditional media and then going back and using it. Like, I've been really adoring making these postcard prints, being able to put all of my Sharpies and markers to use, and then being able to kind of, like, print it and use it. I'm picking up some signals that may be coming from other castaways in the most recently discovered area. There could be a stranded rescue officer out there. We're counting on you to rescue them. Preferably very soon. Yeah, I'm ready to explore. Welcome in, raiders! Hi, Zephyr! Welcome in! You're here just in time. We finished our announcement, and it's time for some Pikmin. What were you up to, Zephyr? Ooh, more of the Lunar Silver Star story. I remember you said it was very JRPG, very nostalgia heavy. Meanwhile, this is my first ever Pikmin experience, so I'm kind of like on the other end of the spectrum there. Well, welcome in, raiders. If you don't know me, my name is Redria. I am a full-time scientist, part-time streamer, and I play a lot of farming sims, sandbox games, and platformers. In the meantime, I am going to play a little video for you and perform a song. I don't know why my stream manager keeps freezing on me, so I can't tell if, like, it's actually keeping up with me. I really hope it is. It looks like it is. You should be done with Lunar tomorrow. This will be your first look at Pikmin 4. I'm on the 5th day, so I'm still very early on as far as the game itself goes. I've gotten through the tutorial, and I'm in the first actual, like, level, for lack of a better phrase. Anyway, let me play this little video for you. Keep going and growing, a raid is showing. Raiders, welcome in. How was stream? What did you play? Hey, thanks for dropping by. I understand if you can't stay. Hey. My name is Redria, and I'm a part-time streamer, full-time scientist, and full-time dreamer. Hope you're having an awesome time today. I'll lead the way. I play platformers, sandbox games, farming sims, come watch all three. I'm on TikTok, YouTube, Twitter, and Twitch TV. Like what you see, there's no need to wallow. Find me again, go on and click that follow. Please refresh your streams, and then your free pronouns, they, she. Welcome, Zephyr Raiders. Welcome in. Let me show you some of the announcements that we were working on showing off. So first things first, I'm starting a monthly Ko-fi membership tier. So the $4 tier will get you 4 stickers plus a postcard print, and the $8 tier will add in a physical early bloomers pin, which is the silver pin in the bottom right. The way I'm branding it is that it's a bunch of goodies about baddies, because they're, you know, they're usually considered baddies in the Super Mario universe. So I'm excited to kind of explore what might be thematically appropriate as the months go by. And also something worth mentioning is that the $8 beanlet tier, you also get to participate in polls to help suggest or select baddies for future months. On top of that, oops, I meant to have this up. On top of that, we are showing off our brand new September 2023 official merchandise. We do charity streams. This is the second time we have done Souptember. And basically, it is a month of games based around soup and cooking soup and all sorts of soup-themed shenanigans. And we raise money for a food kitchen. So this year, we are supporting World Central Kitchen and their Chefs for Hawaii initiative. It's a goal, or it's a cause that is near and dear to my heart. So I'm very excited that everything kind of lined up at the perfect time. I mean, it is unfortunate that there's a need for charity work, but isn't that always the case? I do love soup. You are among a good crowd then. And let's see, the last... Oops, well, that's not what I meant to do. The last announcement was that the Pikmin prints are available on my Ko-fi. So we will pin this so that you may find them later. We did a bunch of Pikmin trading cards. So the physical trading cards are going to Dennis because they won first on this stream. And the they can be reprinted and sent out as postcards. Anyway, thank you so much for the raid, Zephyr. Any of the raiders, if you've got a lurk, if you've got a head out, I understand. But I hope you enjoy some Pikmin. Let me know how the audio is, by the way. So, at the end of last stream, we just unlocked this second zone, Blossoming Arcadia. We've confirmed another SOS signal in this area. One of our missing rescue officers may be waiting for us here. There an echo of my microphone? Microphone. Or do you mean of the Switch gameplay? There probably is. I can get rid of that though. No, it's faint. But I don't want to get rid of my desktop volume because a lot of my stream stuff comes through the desktop. Open volume mixer. Doesn't help that the music's super quiet right now. So anyway, no, I want to go back here. Is the audio still okay, or is it too quiet now? Copy that. All right, so now we can wait for those pellets to turn yellow. and we can get more yellow men. How are you finding the game difficulty? Not super difficult yet. I did throw just a bunch of little men into the void, so we're having a memorial service for them today. But other than that, it's been puzzly. It's been kind of like an efficiency equation, which I really like, actually. Oh, they will cycle through the color. Oh, okay. Well, see, I thought maybe they had to actually, like, pick it up when it's yellow for its account. This is very efficient. Yeah, mostly I just want to get more of the yellow men. I don't have many of the little yellow men. Alright. So now I need 20 of the Icemen to go do, I think this is a Dandori battle. When yellow Pikmin transport a red palette, they get less sprouts. As opposed to the yellow palettes, huh? Well, that's good to know. So that means, like, have the yellow Pikmin attack the yellow palette so that they will carry it, kind of. Let's do that. I didn't want all of the Pikmin to die, was the thing. I didn't know if they would all die if they were still there. I will do that. Okay, so now he gets to be in land and I get to watch every single one drown. I'm not trying. All right. Say, if they'll all just come with me, then that's fine. I was not expecting to not be able to get up there. All right. So now what we can do. Grab all of our men. And do that. And everything's fine. It's fine. We have all of our little men. Oh, we're gonna beat up Beanie now, huh? I'm sorry, Ochi, I didn't mean to make you swim. Dandori Daycare. This is my second Dandori battle. This place is for testing Dandori. Do more Dandori. Improve Dandori. Simple goal. Carry as much as you can until time ends. That is all. Carry as much as you can. Treasure here, all fake. This one is a little different. It's not a 1v1. Okay. So they're not all just battles like the first one was. Pikmin here, all mine. Also cannot take home. This means, can Dandori forever? This is bliss for me. And you. Do well. Get raw material. Do not well. Also get raw material. You wish to take me from here. Show me your best, Dandori. There's two varieties. One versus one. And this version where you just try to carry as much as possible. Okay, well, I like this. Oh, I didn't see you here. So I lost some good little men. I already forget the rush attack. He's gonna unlock a shortcut. I see. They're gonna have to keep, they're gonna have to keep passing enemies, which I don't want them to do. Owie. See, I got Ochi busy over there, so I'm learning that I'm not doing this well yet. Alright. Alright, we have this shortcut unlocked now, so let's do some stuff. Alright, we have, All right, we need 12. I didn't see anywhere to get more Pikmin yet. Let's have Ochi start digging. Oh, I see. I can't get back up there while Ochi is digging. Wrong button. I'm trying! Okay. Doing good for a first try. I can tell I'm already learning a lot. Rope. That's new. Probably not enough time to get it. Probably. I surpassed 69. 12 more for a bronze medal. Do I need a bronze medal? Yes. Your Dandori needs work, but you never gave up to the very end. I give you 10 raw materials. Try again. Let's try again. I've learned a lot just my first playthrough of this. So I don't want them carrying anything right now. Owie. You will come to understand that every single Pikmin matters. I don't even think I had 30 for a lot of the challenge, if I'm being honest. Alright, I need Ochi to... take care of that. I don't know if they can get to me or not! They're trying! Oh, I fell, but it's okay. We're pretty close. I'm now seeing that shortcut too. They were just hiding in there, huh? What are we missing? Oh, I've got some stuck up here on the climbing rope. Sillies. So that's the only other thing I probably could have started working on earlier, was the gold pile. Let's see how I did this time. Okay. I will take it. You work too fast. I feel dizzy. Take these 30 pieces raw material. This is your reward. It was the- I'm getting better at visualizing where I can't and can't go, because I'm used to a platformer where I can always jump, but you can only jump when you are riding Ochi. So I think what I would have been better off doing is, like, putting my Pikmin to use, while Ochi was pulling on the little tree, but hey, I'll take the improvement. Oh my, they fainted. I wonder what caused that. Well, I guess this is our chance to get them out of here. That's Dandori, baby! You know what else is Dandori? Me making my rice in the, like, exact 30 minutes before stream started, so I didn't have to worry about doing it later. With all that leaf growth, there's no way to tell who this is. But it doesn't matter. It's our job to rescue them. We don't want them finding their way back inside that cave. Let's keep the lid closed, as a precaution. Do I need the ice right now? I do need the ice. That way they can carry this person across. Another leafy castaway. Hopefully their ID will tell us something. Error. Unable to read data. No luck. Could the leaves be causing this error? Probably. Thank you. trying to remember where I was headed. I know that that Dandori battle was the last thing I had seen. How do I get over there? Check your map for stars. Yes. Okay, this was the electric fence that we broke. Like, I see this here, but I don't know that I can get to it. Nope. Cannot. Like, I see those there, but I don't know how to get up there. Onion over there. Oh, we're at 70% now. I just can't figure out how to get up over there. Is this a thing? Aha! It was just a matter of finding my way over here. Alright. Oh. And one more cave. Alright, do I have to wait for them to do their thing before I go in, right?
Oh, hey!
I noticed you looking at the radar map just now. Why don't I tell you about a handy little function it has?
Oi.
The system will mark discovered caves and cleared areas with these arrow markings. You go to that spot, the symbol disappears. It's a very useful way to keep track of your objectives. Cool. Yeah, I'm not ready for them to stop yet, so what I might do is... I would have the yellow Pikmin do this, but... they're all busy. New gear is now available. You can throw more Pikmin than needed to increase the speed. Yeah, I forgot how long it takes for the large pellets to get broken. That is midday. All right, now we're gonna go in that little cave. Let's go. There's lava! I was feeling hotter than usual in my spacesuit, and when I looked down, the ground was on fire. I panicked, but a red Pikmin just gave me a sidelong glance, totally unfazed, even as the fire licked at them. They're clearly capable of more than just skillful attacks. Oh, okay, so even with carrying stuff. Let's do that. We don't want any ice men coming in with us.
Woo!
Hi, Gage. Welcome to Pikmin. Ooh, we had some big art announcements earlier, Gage. Well done, little men. So this is day two, the second Pikmin stream. The yellow ones can break that. That's a shortcut to be unlocked later. What were the announcements? Well, I am glad you asked. Let me head back this way, and I'll show you. We can't jump there yet. You killed a little yellow carrot. Did I? Listen, I don't want to talk about- we're having a memorial service because, six brave little Pikmin during my last stream ended up throwing themselves into the void for reasons beyond my comprehension. And I appreciate their service ever so greatly. So anyway, the first of our announcements. Get rid of the tab, did I? I did. How did I do that? Throwing themselves. I'm sticking to that story. I don't care that I have a clip. Alright, hold on. First things first. Oh, don't do that. Stop it. Why are you like this? There we go. First announcement is the official September 2023 shirts are here. And they are available for purchase over on my fourth wall shop. And $10 from each shirt sale is going to be donated directly to World Central Kitchen Chefs for Hawaii. They called us superheroes, and I took that to heart, and I decided to make that our merch design for the year. So... it was a little bit of a combination, like a little brainstorm session. Biscuit had the idea of the soup spoon being in there, and I kind of, like, thought of it as a broom, and then a soup witch was born, and then it was a superhero. So that's our first little art announcement. I'm very excited about how they have turned out so far. The second announcement is... we have new postcard designs available in the Ko-fi shop. They are based on the Pikmin trading card series that I did. Each postcard print is $3, and I mail internationally. It'll just be a little 4x6, kind of a cardstock material postcard. And I... truly love how this set came out. This was even before I had decided I was playing Pikmin, that I was like, oh, I'll do little Pikmin trading cards, because, you know, sometimes you just want something to do some traditional art with. And then lastly, the last announcement is we are starting a Ko-fi membership tier. There will be two tiers, the Sprout tier and the Beanlit tier. And you can spend money on the Ko-fi membership and get monthly goodies from me. We are calling them goodies of baddies because they're going to be based on Super Mario Baddie. The month of September, all of the designs are available. There will be four stickers, a traditional postcard print, and a physical early bloomers pin if you are in the Beanlit tier. So, I had a lot of fun making this today. Copics, Sharpies, the works. And then kind of scanning it in digitally. So yeah, that's our announcement. Let's see if we can get back into this cave. Alright, they broke this. We're safe. No, I definitely have thought of that, Gage, because that was my main reason for being scared of trying something like this. Is just, you know, there's always that thought of like, well, now I have to do this, now I have to do that. And, you know, just, I want to keep things chill. Alright, first things first. I already have the baddie in mind for September. Or sorry, for October. And one of the most important things I was doing is keeping the sticker designs very simple. Like, two of them are recolors. And they will be recolors month to month, but, you know, that just kind of makes it special. It's the monthly beans, or the monthly, coffee cup. Alright, so we did lose two little men. I think we lost two of the Pikmin to, the Fly Guys. Alright. No, we only lost one? No, we didn't. Okay. There they go. Welcome in, Nat. Oh, they're digging. Let's see. I didn't even see them there. Ooh, good Starbits roll. How's it going, Nat? You're counting down the end days. Yeah, congratulations on starting your new job soon. Alright, my treasure gauge turned off. So I think that means it's time to go to the other door I found, if I can find it again. Oh, come on, that's so mean. Are they singing a little song to me, Dennis? I didn't know they sang! That's too cute! That's so cute, it hurts. Also, we did earlier do a giveaway of the physical Pikmin trading cards, and they were awarded to the person who got first today. There's actually like 5 different songs they can sing. That's so cute. You need more magic in your life, Nat. Huh? There must be a castaway nearby. Fear not, Nat. We are resetting the early bloomers. We're resetting the stats. Alright. Yeah, the stats get reset every 3 months. Just keeps things fresh. They're digging up a yam. I think they're digging up a yam. Yeah, man, it's a yam! I love how they ended in yam formation. Perfect. I see the castaway. Let's hop aboard. So Nat, we got to show off the Souptember official shirt. We also got to show off our brand new Ko-fi postcard prints, and we're starting a Ko-fi membership tier with some physical goodies about some baddies. I love that shirt. I cannot wait to buy one. I hope so too. I did, I sent it to them in an email because they were in my inbox. Oh, I don't want to go here yet. I'm gonna get lost. Oh, I was just about to break through that wall. Alright, let's check that ID.
Oh, what?
Look who we have here. Dingo! An officer who excels at solo missions. He's not a joiner by nature, but he'll show up and lend his physical abilities when need be.
The bomb.
I knew it. I knew he was tough enough to make it. Dingo is a skilled ranger, even though he does not use a rescue pup. He specializes in solo missions, you see. One thing's for certain. Rescue missions should be a lot easier with his help. We found the ranger. What kind of voice should he have? You tracked down our ranger, Dingo. The only rescue officers still out there now are the doctor and the pilot. There's Colin, Shepard. Oh, that's an enemy. That's like a slug. And he's on top of some little men. Let's go get a full squad. Squad up. Careful, this one can squish your men. Not on my watch. I mean, maybe on my watch. Well, now I can't let you die! No men were lost. In Pikmin 2, they hum the Luigi's Mansion theme. That is adorable. Oops. Excellent Dandori skill. You mean me remembering that the rush attack exists? Because yes, I agree. Thousand sparklium. It is quite sparkly. Alright. Let's go into these underground bits and be serenaded. Oh, it's a shortcut. Oh, I'm silly. Here I am thinking it's like a whole maze that I need to figure out. And I forgot I could do that. You know what? It's fine. We got everything over here. I think we're ready to go. The treasure gauge is gone, so I think we're done. Enjoy your work, Lurk Nat. Nat, if you're still there, real quick, I'm going to show you the monthly rewards for the month of September. And I'm probably gonna start on the month of October immediately so that I can, not fall behind. But it is 4 stickers and a postcard print for the Sprout tier, and then the Beanlet tier adds on a physical Early Bloomers pin. I'm very excited about how this turned out. I know, the coffee cup, and, like, that's the cool thing, is the coffee cup and the beans are just gonna be recolored every month based on the baddie of the month. Look at all that sparkly SS chocolate cookie of nibbled circles. Daughter of the Earth. I misread that as Destroyer of the Earth. I don't know what is so deceptive about that snack. Illumination goo? Is that what minions are made of? I picked up a lot of material this time around, so I should be able to afford some upgrades, I think. ...75% of area, huh? I'm missing something over here. That I might be able to reach if I go... if I stay up here. Ah, yes, I need... material. Oh! Ah! Ah! Okay. I think I lost a little man. Okay. Let's go follow them. Dennis says, there's a cute Easter egg to the paint colors you can find. You can find one tube for each Pikmin color. And not only that, but the red, blue, and yellow are mostly used up. The white and purple are a little fuller. The pink and gray are hardly used. And the green and light blue are brand new. Because they represent how old the respective Pikmin types are. That does make sense. It's a cute detail. My little men better hurry up. That is a really neat little detail. I think I remember having another tube of refreshing goo or something like that. Where's my last man? Oh, you're at the ship. Okay. I don't know that I feel like it's that much faster to try to dash anywhere you go, because there's that long, slow pause that you do. Oh, that's right, I have to say end day. A good day. I figured out how to get to the next area that I haven't been to here. Where are the castaways? I'm asking Inky. I think he knows. You can 100% clear every area before moving on to the next, if you choose to do so. It doesn't seem to make much of a difference either, because, like, it's not like the cave I did today was a bust. I found a member of our crew! So, like, it's still pretty important, like, story stuff that's happening here. We can do some training with Ochi. Oh, what is this star-shaped metal? Russ tinkered with the appraisal AI. Now you'll be able to see when you've collected all the
Banana!
Banana. There's resonance in the wave patterns for treasures of the same type that let us extract even more sparklium. Can't say that I get the science behind it, but it sounds like we should try to collect a complete series. So I'm gonna guess that the paint is a complete series.
Honey.
Well, Captain, we did it. We finally found our Ranger Dingo. Can't believe I had to be saved by the newbie. I'm losing my itch.
Oh,
no. We're just glad to see you made it back safe and sound, Dingo. Are you hurt at all?
Ooh.
Not at all, Captain. I'm just a touch that you care. This table does not seem to be structurally sound. It's missing screws. Science guy could stand to worry a little more. That reminds me, Captain. I have some information regarding our pilot. Really? Do you know his whereabouts? Great work, Dingo. No, that's not exactly. You must be exhausted from all that forced sleep you had. We'll go over the details tomorrow. Go get some rest. Huh? You got it, Captain. She cares about my physical state, that means. She cares. Oh, before you hit the hay, please be sure to review all the details related to our rescue mission so you're fully prepared. Is that really necessary? Yes. Dingo, is it true that you encountered our pilot while stranded? Well, yeah. Ran into Bernard at some point, but he got, like, snatched up by a leaf creature. Leaf? What? We saw the leaf creature pick up someone else and toss him on a big pup. Bernard and I tried to follow, but we were too late. Dragged the castaway into a cave, and suddenly they were growing leaves, too. Like this one? Yeah, exactly. The castaway turned into something just like that. So then the leaf creature in charge spotted us. We got out of there as fast as we could, or at least that's what I thought. When I turned around, Bernard was gone. Maybe he didn't make it out, or maybe he got turned into a leafling too. Hey, what's this leafling doing here, anyway? And why are they unconscious? Is this your work, comms guy? Obviously not. And I have no idea why they're currently unconscious. It was Red who recovered them. But based on what you're saying, this leafling could potentially be Bernard? Potentially. By the way, Bernard and I sort of coined the term leafling. We came up with it because they all have all those leaves growing out of their heads. Pretty clever, I know. This castaway may be our pilot, but undoing his leafy state is beyond our expertise. We need to rescue these leaflings, but without a doctor, there's not much else we can do. We need to find Yanni, Stat. Officers, to your stations, please. Copy that, Captain. Alright. Training, training, and more training. Talk to the scientist too to see both tabs. Yep, I am planning on looking at everything I can. Alright, I would like to save up to get some heal. Or, no, maybe I want to keep buffing. We'll keep buffing. Good boy. Who, Master Chump? Was it you? Yes, yes, Ochi, it was you. Good boy. Now you should be ready to learn an even more powerful skill. Big Chomp! Wow, they're really good at naming things. How do I... Ochi gets all the bones. I don't even know what they do. Ochi gets the bones. I've created a new item. Well, I developed a prototype with the materials I had on hand. You'll have to come see for yourself. The bones heal them, so you're kind of wasting them. It's a treat for a good boy. Let's visit the lab. So we have gear and items. Oh, I can buy more. Ooh. These are the consumables. I am actually intrigued about the bomb rock.
Hello, hello.
Oh, you get one for free. One of each. Yeah, I can't say that I have had much of an issue with the difficulty of this game yet. I have lost a couple of Pikmin here and there, some by, complete user error, and some just by, you know, they got eaten by enemies. But what I will say is, I haven't noticed my own health getting low yet during any sort of fights. It is very beginner-friendly. Well, that's good to know. We'll hold off on that for now. And you. Tell me, how is the treasure collection coming along? You know, I'm more than happy to appraise every valuable you find. I forget, I'm just able to look at what I've found already, right? He doesn't have anything else for me. I love the rubber cutie. Ah, fret not, stately rubber cutie. Yes, you may be smallish in size, but that does not matter. Cute is cute.
In fact, it's quite possible you're even more cute because of your smallness. Yes, I do believe you are. I need to know why this snack is lying. This treasure takes a sophisticated palate to appreciate. First, a salty sweet sauce is put atop some kind of white food stuff. It's then fried and topped with a thin black layer of paper? It sounds awful, but it tastes wonderful. Surprising in the best way. I don't know what this is. SS Chocolate. It was this adorable ship's yummy smell that lured me in. Then suddenly I was taking a bite. Lo and behold, I found the ship to be edible. In fact, it's chocolate flavored. I'm still not quite sure what to make of this discovery. All I know is it's a delicious one. Might be a soy sauce snack. I've had those before and they're interesting. Okay. I didn't know if the paper was nori. Just based on the visual. And all relaxed now. Dingo's back. Don't know how the rescue corps made it this long without me. Guess I'll find out soon enough, since the captain's making me rest up a bit before I get back into action. I love how she's like, you must be so exhausted from napping for so long. Go rest. We're all set over here. The SS Beagle can take off whenever you're ready. Which area would you like to explore? Well, I just found somewhere new in this unspeckled terrace, so we're going back. I'm still checking my email, or checking my phone for that phone call. I do seem to be dragging their feet, but that was a job that was open as of May. So I shouldn't be surprised at this point. She's twitching his nose. That means there's treasure nearby? I mean, does it? I don't think so. I need one more ice Pikmin. And then I can freeze that bigger pond. So I might make that part of my goal today. They're just reminding me of his abilities. Am I supposed to get there from here? That, Larlick? No. Maybe. Yes. Just wanted to make sure that 5 was enough to carry it. Oh, they left this corpse here. Overnight. That's beautiful. Isn't nature astounding? Enemies in the overworld don't respawn. Oh. We can take out 10 more Pikmin now. This should speed up our search. New cave discovered. I may as well go in, actually, because all of my Pikmin are back there. They've all finished their tasks. I knew I saw that up there, I just don't know how to get it yet. Aquiferous Summit. I found a hole that should lead out to the top of the mountain. But the inside was more convoluted than expected. And only now do I see a light at the end of the tunnel. If I ever make it out of this place, I'll deserve a good rest. Let's go! I don't recommend any yellows. Surprising. The auto-select of the Pikmin kind of does end up telling you something. Yellow Schmellow, who needs them? Ochi is yellow. That should be enough. Oh, you know what? I see what I did. Was there not a dig spot there? I definitely thought this was going to be a dig spot. Why are you doing that? It's a Zen garden. Yeah, I guess I thought it looked like it should be breakable. I don't know. Waiting for the treasure gauge to turn off, and it did. It was a really quiet little pop. Oh, the sparklium in the egg, not sap. Could it be the doctor? We're gonna find out. Hold on, stop, what are you doing? Is it a building thing? Is he building something here? Yes. I couldn't see the little icon there. I'm not ready to go that way yet. And why are they just sitting here? There you are. There we go. All together again. I love how I needed just one. Pikmin are having trouble. I know, they gave me so many. Oh, it's just gonna stay down. That's pretty nice. Right, there's still some stuff in here, I believe. It's our castaway. Checking their ID. I hope it's another rescue officer, like our doctor or pilot. He loves animals and they love him. A researcher at heart, his passion for other creatures is as genuine as his smile. He appears to be an animal enthusiast. He must have seen the voyage log and came here looking for new species. Luckily, we found him before he got, well, eaten. How many civilians decided it'd be a good idea to go traipsing off to this planet? Did they think this was some kind of a hot new tourist destination or something? They did. Let's see, am I gonna 100% the sun-speckled terrace? I still have that one treasure to get yet. Skin of the Phoenix. I probably can readjust my webcam then, because I don't think I'm gonna have a physical guest in the foreseeable future. Maybe some in-person Overcooked with my sister. That would be a good Soup-tember thing, I think. New base unlocked. Well done, little man. Huh, I think that red stuff is... Uh-huh, look at that red nectar. I wonder. Ultra spicy spray. A spray consisting of red nectar infused with ultra spicy compounds. Side effects still unknown. I believe this is that ultra-spicy nectar that was mentioned in the voyage log. Keep that sample sealed up in a bottle so it won't spill in your pack. Did Ochi not just eat it? There's a decent amount of ultra-spicy essence there. It should be useful. I keep forgetting I have bombs. Your pack is Ochi's stomach. Alright, and those 9 other men need to be picked. I thought it would move the sprouts here. I really thought it would move the sprouts. Oh, I can't get it yet. Hi, Windu! I'm gonna have to go down this way. This way. And back up this way. Take care, Nat. Thank you for stopping by. They're so cute. 75 times. That's respectable. We are on our second episode of Pikmin 4. There is a hidden treasure in this area, by the way. Oh, wait. Ah, man. Sad. Sad. I can't get back there without going through the cave, can I? I didn't even realize. That's a bummer. Forget that silly fruit. Thankfully, it's already cleared, so we just gotta run through. So I can use Ochi to sniff. Do a little shout out section. I've been enjoying Pikmin a lot for someone who has never played a Pikmin game before. It's very different. I don't even think I had a reason for not playing Pikmin. Like, it's not like I looked at it and said, ooh, this looks like it's not for me. Or, like, I tried it and said, oh, I'm bad at this. It's the only one that's hidden. That's kind of weird. That makes me wonder if it's intentional, you know? Yeah, I guess when I went into the cave and came out, I didn't put two and two together that it was different from the other caves, that I was, like, entering somewhere and exiting somewhere else. Until the remaster, there wasn't a good way to play Pikmin anyway, unless you wanted to buy hardware. That's also true. Now, I don't have the remaster. I don't know how much I am interested in it. Just because, I mean, I'm enjoying this, but I've heard that this was kind of, like, better, in a sense. Just that it kind of optimized a lot of things. Oh, good. It left the dragon fruit here. Then it says, I prefer playing with a Wiimote. Interesting. Wasn't the original Pikmin GameCube? Okay, I'm still missing something over here. I never had a Wii U. What an excellent treasure. A peanut buried in some dirt. That is not the hidden treasure. That's fine. I saw it on the mini-map, so I thought... Are you guys becoming besties based on the Wii U? Yeah, I think... So I was in college. I was mostly playing games on my laptop at that point because I needed the laptop with me anyway. And I just, as a college student, having to buy it myself, kind of decided, yeah, I don't know if I want to do that. Okay, remind me, is the anthill a good thing? I don't want to throw my little men into it. Windu says, I wouldn't say it's underrated. It made its expectations. Virtual console side of things was amazing. Big spot here? This one would be the hidden one. Yeah, that's weird. That feels like an oversight. Years later, it's a good device. Well, before they closed the eShop. Potato! Nintendo lost a lot of money on the Wii U. Yeah, didn't I hear something recently that they were going to bring the 3DS eShop back online or something? Or am I getting my wires crossed? I remember reading an article somewhat recently, and it was about something that Nintendo had said they were done with that they were bringing back, but I forget the specifics. Yeah, the name alone is kind of silly. 99% Sun Speckled Terrace. I think it's just this Flarlic bulb, so now I need to go get... I need to go back to my previous campsite, swap out to the ice. Might not be able to do it today. I would love it if I could. No! Start singing again. It was really cute. Hi Shay, welcome in. Let's get those bits. Don't know if I have time for this. Oh. Nope. Okay. How's Pikmin going? Not bad. I'm racing against the clock here. Photo finish! We picked a lot of Min today. I will go back over our announcements from earlier. Inky is sleeping so peacefully on the bed right now. It is incredible. So, our first announcement. First announcement is that I am launching some brand new Ko-fi memberships. There are two different monthly tiers. One is the Sprout tier, and one is the Beanlit tier. So each month, there will be a set of goodies based on baddies. For the month of September, we're starting with the Octo guy, because I thought it looked kind of autumn-ish. The Sprout tier will get 4 stickers and a postcard print. And the Beanlit tier will get 4 stickers, a postcard print, a physical early bloomers pin, and they will get access to participate in polls to help pick future baddies for the monthly themes. Nothing bad happens when the timer runs out. Oh, I didn't know that. So it's just if you have Pikmin idle somewhere that, like, they would not make it. So, anyway, this is going to be launching as of today. You are able to join as a Ko-fi member and get some little physical goodies. Oh yeah, I keep forgetting to unhide this. This is the coffee cup sticker of the month. So yeah, each month is going to have a coffee cup, a cookie, a beans, and a baddie sticker of the month. And then of course the physical early bloomers pin as well. And then, of course, the added bonus is I can just put the early bloomers pin of the month into the rotation. So if anyone really likes the Octo guy, kind of looks like an Octo Rock. Yeah, good job, Nintendo. Okay, so second announcement is we have official Souptember shirts available. Sorry, I went to the wrong one. Okay, second announcement is actually that the Pikmin postcard prints are available on Ko-fi. I lied. I will show you the shirts in just a moment. But we have 5 different postcard prints available. You can choose your favorite. You can collect them all. It's entirely up to you how you want to do it. Pictember! That's cute. And of course, the lucky person who managed to snag first today ended up winning the physical trading card. So again, congratulations, Dennis. I will be sending them your way. Let's see. Lastly, we have a brand new shirt in the shop celebrating Souptember. Check this out. The people from World Central Kitchen saw that I created a charity campaign called Souptember, and they were so fascinated by it, they emailed me to ask me about it. So, they, after a little bit of back and forth, called us superheroes. And lo and behold, that became the perfect merchandise piece for our official Souptember shirts. Wow, does Dennis even like Pikmin? They never talk about it. Yeah, I'm not sure. So, right now, the shirt is available in a lot of fall colors. If anybody really feels strongly about having it in another color, please reach out to me. I'm happy to put another color in the lineup. It's absolutely free. And this shirt will only be available during the month of Souptember. After that, it's going away. $10 from every shirt sale will get donated directly to World Central Kitchen, Chefs for Hawaii. That's our cause for Soup-tember this year. So I'm very excited. I love this design. And I hope you guys like it too. Okay. I think that's most of the announcements. So, let's get back to some Pikmin. Yeah, I love that shirt. I think I just have that garlic to get. We rescued an animal enthusiast earlier. Okay, so the sweet potato was the daughter of the earth, and the potato is the child of the earth. That raises a lot of questions. By the way, Red, if you press minus and open shortcut settings, you can assign different functions to your buttons. Really? Can you assign the rescue journal to one of those? Of course, and then you could reference it whenever you need some quick advice. You can even assign actions like disband or select items at the push of a button. Setting up shortcuts seems like a great way to improve your Dandori practice. Speaking of improvements, Colin, it would be more efficient if you shared such helpful information a lot sooner. The Earth is having babies! And they're potatoes. Is our ranger still resting? No, he's not. So wait, who are you? No. Hiya there, the name's Kingsley. I run a flower shop back home. I actually came to this planet to find rare flowers, then things took a turn. One second I'm gazing at a glorious bud, and the next thing I know, I'm stranded. So yeah, I've had enough adventure for the time being. I don't think I'll be doing much more exploring around here. Potabies! Oh, okay, tenderfoot. Let's see what you're made of. Don't give me that look. You can handle some extra credit work. Check out every inch of this planet until you've explored each area 100%. Okay. Copy that. That's where I was going anyway, buddy. If you're not sure what you need to do next, you can always check your missions for some ideas. We're 100%ing this level. Because I can end the day as soon as it's done. Do these Olimars not know how to land properly? How did y'all get stranded? Yeah, so they sent an entire rescue team of like 7, I think, people after Olimar when they got his distress signal. The rescue team's ship crashed. There's some sort of lore that, like, I don't know if it's the gravity of this planet or something, 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 but, like, it seems like it takes everyone by surprise when they arrive and they crash land. All right, we want 30 ice Pikmin. Red, come in. Over. Ochi has never really liked getting wet, but I've been working on it with him in the bathtub aboard the SS Shepherd. Last night he had a big breakthrough. Your rescue pup can swim. Wet. Now that he's over his dislike of water, he can jump in and use doggy paddle to swim through any water obstacle. Get on Ochi's back with the Pikmin, and you can ride across bodies of water to explore new areas. What? Ochi, my boy! Do I not need 30 Iceman anymore? I'm taking him anyway, because I don't know. Yeah, maybe someday I will get good at using... Actually, I have the ice bomb. Okay, never mind, it's temporary. Interesting. I know, the doggy paddle is cute. And now it looks like I could do that and just swim, but I think I need these little guys for some building stuff. Okay, you're not gonna be smart enough to go grab materials without being told. So what I think is this vent is a way to get back across the water.
Oh, hey.
Yes.
Are?
Watch this one little man work. Look at you go, little buddy. Hi, Fudge. Welcome home. Did you see I got the rice made up and the roast is tasting amazing? It's so weird that they sit there. Your shift went well, Fudge. Bark. Come on. Because I need all of you guys. All right, so Ochi can swim now. Get him! Alright. Onions really do come in all kinds of different colors. Could there be one for every Pikmin type? No, that would make too much sense. Oh, wait. Hold on. Unless... Can they take the vent? They cannot take the vent. But you guys can go that way. Okay. Wow, we've collected quite a lot of those red berries now. Ooh, ultra spicy berries. After thorough analysis, it appears that these berries contain large amounts of ultra spicy essence. I suggest you squeeze 10 of them and put the resulting extract into your pack. Never know when you'll need it. Okay. So here's the deal. I need 20 of the Icemen to melt the ice again. I think the last 5 are back at the ship. Maybe, or maybe they're on their way to the ship? Are my little men? Why did you go back there? They keep doing that. Like, I don't- oh, there you are. You're still getting the berries. Okay, good. Never mind. Welcome back, Dennis. We have to refreeze the pond so that we can transport the garlic over. I fell! That bites. No. Dang it. Well, now what do I do? Stop what you're doing. Aren't the ice ones able to transport it? Not across this. Not according to... I gotta upgrade Ochi even more. Maybe I do. I was trying to figure out if there was a way to puzzle through this. Can't get up here, huh? There goes that idea. Hmm. Yeah. What happens if you throw 20 ice ones on it? It still doesn't work. That's what happened last time. Bummer, because this was literally the last thing I had in this level to do. And I was really hoping to just do it, you know? Like, I kind of wondered whether it was an order of operations thing, where if I, like, froze and then unfroze at the last second. And I'm surprised the Pikmin can't use the little air vent, because I thought I've seen them do that before. But they don't seem to be able to use it. I won't be able to upgrade Ochi until I get some more pup drive, which I think I'm gonna need to do it through getting more castaways. They can use it, but not with the treasure, I see. And they could transport the berries through the little gaps, but the garlic is too big. Yep, I guess we move on. It'll be a very easy thing to come back for. Especially if it stays moved where I have it, it's just going to be a matter of getting there. Yeah, it's either going to be upgrading Ochi, or it's going to be getting a different garlic so I can carry more little men. No matter how much I look at them, I'm still confounded. These treasures are mysterious things. Indeed, who made them, and for what possible purpose? Think back to that treasure we found in the first day, the Stone of Advancement. It was able to open and close, right? Maybe it was intended as some sort of makeshift shelter to protect its creator from the wind and the rain. Interesting theory, though likely incorrect. It was the Game Boy Advance SP. That was the Stone of Advancement. Captions, are you there? Captions, hello. Testing, testing. I don't know why they stopped. They were taking a little nap. No, I actually got scared, though, that, like, my internet was dropping or something, because when the captions stop, that's usually why, is because the internet stopped. Do I have any pup points? I don't think I do. I have one. Is it buff? It is buff. Well, that's mildly annoying. No, I'm just mildly annoyed because now I can just go 100% the level, so I'm gonna do it. We're gonna do it. I'm not always the kind to, like, 100% a level before moving on to the next one, but if it's not a level that requires you to go back and forth, it makes sense. I want that blue garlic, damn it! So close. So, importantly, how are you guys enjoying this Pikmin 4 playthrough? And how familiar are you with the Pikmin series? I don't think Dennis likes Pikmin. I've never heard them talk about it. Dennis says, I'm surprised that this game has no backtracking at all. Pikmin 1, 2, and 3 all did. That is surprising. And I'm not gonna say it's a bad thing to have a game that has backtracking. I just think that there's a balance to be struck. Alright, let's go solve this puzzle that we already know how to solve, and then we'll leave immediately. I see that there's a lot of the, materials here. You're right. Dennis got me a Pikmin game years ago. I liked it, but never finished it. Yeah, Ochi is a very cute addition. Baby! The more onions we fuse together, the more type of Pikmin it can propagate. That's good news for us. 100%. Oh, can they not do anything either? I guess not. Are you gonna just yell at me? We haven't seen Pikmin like these before. I wonder if Captain Olimar ever encountered anything like them. The blue Pikmin. At a glance, the blue Pikmin appear to have mouth-like gills and are notably able to function even underwater. Thanks to their water resistance and swimming talents, I can now transport things found in the water. That makes sense. I was literally just wondering why I couldn't get the stuff out of the bottom of the water here. I could focus on getting more blues. What? Why can't these Pikmin come out? According to the voyage log, only 3 types of Pikmin can be out on the surface at any given time. They really have developed a lot of protective traits to keep their species from getting totally wiped out. Thank you. So now I could just run around the map getting more blue Pikmin. Ooh, I see that tenor. Live my little farmer life. I don't know what the tadpole is good for. If anything. Maybe a little bit of, like, resource or whatever. Raw materials. Attack it and bring it to the onion for Pikmin. Is it worth doing? Gives two sprouts, I think. Eh, it's not bad. I am looking for some pellets. Listen to them hustle. I could move base, but I'm kind of, like, trying to look around and see where these are. You almost got left behind, little buddy! I think that's one of the reasons I try not to throw too many of them at, one of the pellets, because once they're done attacking, only the minimum amount that is required to pick up the pellet will go actually try to pick it up. The rest will just sit there. Though for the bigger ones, it still makes sense because they take so much longer. Now, where are the other pellets at? I'm kind of excited. So tomorrow, we are going to be streaming some Palia and then some Core Keeper later on. And Palia actually is getting its first ever event. Please keep singing to me, Pikmin. Thank you! Thank you! They listen to me! What good little men? Alright, let's move here, grab these, and then haul it. They are the best little singers. All right. New area! We'll check it out. We will do a day in the new area. Because it feels like kind of a waste to not check it out, you know? We 100%ed the previous. We're here, we're ready. Thank you, Dennis. I appreciate that. As a total Pikmin newbie. Investigation complete!
No.
I don't get it. Why do we fight? And why does everything have to be a competition?
What?
Is something the matter, boss?
Marco.
No, just a passing thought I had while watching that Dandori battle. It just strikes me as sad. Here we are, all living together and sharing the same universe. We should be friends, not foes.
Pichu.
Makes sense. But then shouldn't we and, you be friends with all the creatures of the universe as well? Creatures? No, no, that's an entirely different situation. Is it? Day 9! Alright, I'm gonna take a quick 2-minute break, and then we are going to jump in and check out this new level for at least a day before we end stream. So give me just a moment. Shay, you are working the counter here at the Starbeans Cafe. So, everyone, order up. Alrighty. I'm back. It looks like the music just ended, so that's pretty perfect. Oh, there's a Toodumba. Do you feel lucky? Well, do ya? Alright, that's enough of the bad jokes. So we'll do one more day in Pikmin. At least. One more day. One more day. Honestly, I feel like I really enjoy the way that this game is laid out. I kind of miss having games in my life that are set out like levels like this. Yeah, I guess that's kind of the downside to a lot of games trying to push that open world nature, is that it's harder for me to like focus up. And I'm not saying I dislike open world games, but it's just nice to have something that's different like this. Like, it's just so much easier to focus on what I'm doing. I'm gonna agree with you there. A lot of games are trying really hard to push themselves to look like open world games. I actually even feel like Portia's map, my time at Portia, was way bigger than it needed to be. They were going for that open world feel, and they absolutely didn't have to do that for a farming sim. Now, yes, there was some combat in Portia, so there were a couple of reasons to have the map be bigger than, say, your standard Harvest Moon. But I feel like they kind of leaned a little too hard into it to, again, go for that open world feeling. Are those dandelion ducks? Rumor has it that the next story of Seasons is open world. The next Harvest Moon, like the company that bought out the rights to use the name Harvest Moon, did market itself as open world. And it looks kind of half-baked like they usually do. If the next story of Seasons is open world, I don't know how I feel about that. Like, why do you need that? Fragrant Ravine. Like, next they're gonna decide that the next Mario is gonna need to be open world. Almost expecting it at this point. I missed. Are you gonna eat my little men? I don't want you to eat my little men, okay? You're very cute, you are a dandelion duck. And I love you, but you're not allowed to eat my men. But they are just baby. Well, so are my men. My men are also just baby. Just a little baby. I'm scared, though, that that means that they're gonna grow up and not be baby. Aw, thank you, Shay. So it's gonna take 30. I would need to freeze that to get that garlic out of there. But I might be able to do that. Yes, you're right. They're just all busy building right now, that's all. Did somebody say cake? I think so. Shay was nice and shared their cake with everyone. Oops. Perfect. Alright, once they are here, that will be everyone accounted for. The number of Pikmin you can withdraw increased by 10 again. This makes me want to feed that onion even more. I know, the onions keep eating the onions. Let's get more little men! Lots of bridges to construct. You! Come on. Ah, it's that leafling! Be careful. That could be the one who attacked Dingo. Yeah, that's definitely them. Which means that could be Bernard on the ground next to them. Whoever it is, we can't let them get turned into a leafling. Follow them! Is that evil Ochi? Kind of. She's Moss, the puppy dog. And Moss was Olimar's dog. So, you've come again. Those who do not embrace Dandori cannot survive this planet. But if they grow the leaves, we can return them to life. I will determine if you have the strength to save them with a Dandori battle. But this time, there will be one more rule. One must be ready to change tactics at a moment's notice. This round, an object or creature's value can increase for a brief window. These higher values make them bonus finds. When you transport and collect the bonus finds, you can earn double the points. Do you think you can out-Dandori me? IDK, dude! Bonus finds right now are persimmons.
Oh,
don't have any more. Ah, yes, I've increased my Pikmin. No, go ahead. Can I not send any more after that? Doesn't look like it. We did collect a bonus find. It must have changed, like, as we went. We got luck on our side, or is it skill? Two things can be true. They're attacking me. Why'd they do that? So mean of them. Right now, strawberries are hot. They grafted the apple. This one little dude really wants to put the hurtin' on me. I still won. Again, you have shown mastery in the art of Dandori. I leave the rest to you. Off they go again. Thankfully, we recovered the castaway safe and sound. Impressive victory. I think this is the first time the opponent's Pikmin attacked me like that, and I didn't really know what to do about it. Probably need to start, like, charging into them and rushing through them. Transport the castaway to the SS Beagle ASAP. Thank you for the hydrate. Now I escort them to make sure they don't get attacked because I haven't, like, fully cleared this area yet. I probably need to go start collecting more new material. Speaking of. Is that Leaf attacking me or just panicking? Maybe Russ will have more success getting their ID information. I'm gonna guess it reads error. Huh? Does this mean that when someone becomes a Leafling, their biometric authentication data becomes unreadable? If even science isn't able to solve this problem, then I'm afraid I'm at a loss. The Leafs do attack. Well then, the Leaf must die. My character woke up Inky. Play bridge complete! Oh, my little men. There's a cave up here. Midday. I don't know that I can get over there yet. I was gonna try to send people to work on that bridge. But I don't know if I can. New treasure collected. Windu, are you practiced in the fine art of Dandori? You gotta practice up. The opposite. My life feels like a mess. Oh no. Well, that's okay. It's a skill, like I said, that requires practice. It doesn't come naturally to everyone. As someone with ADHD, I really, truly know it does not come naturally to everyone. And it's funny. For so long, I would get mad at myself for, like, needing so many sticky notes and reminders and timers and everything. But then, as an adult, I kind of noticed My mom does that. Like, she was like, oh, I know I'm gonna forget XYZ if you don't tell me. Or, like, I'm gonna forget this if I don't, like, set an alarm or something. And then I asked myself, why am I getting mad about the idea of needing an alarm or a reminder? Like, those things are meant to help us. And it's okay to use those tools. Nothing to feel bad about. Alright, we built this bridge and we didn't do much. Let's move the base here. Sometimes it's not until you give yourself permission to have your life be a little bit messy that you can, like, start working on it. Not to get preachy or anything. Do they really get freaked out about a bunch of bugs? Because that's cute. I may have lost some little men in the scramble. Look, they're playing that Super Mario Golf Rush. It could be like a pride thing. Like, no one wants... I'll say this. Nobody wants to feel like their life is a mess. And yeah, it can be sad to be like, oh, I can't remember to do XYZ unless I explicitly write notes about it. Drink up. Take a sip, babes. What, don't you tell your Pikmin to take a sip, babes? You gotta tell your little men to take a sip, babes. Oh, I didn't know I could do that in the water. This is a really cool level. And, like, it's starting to implement a lot of... Look at me going back to the old location. It's implementing a lot of the things as I get them. Which is kind of a fun way to play a game, in my opinion. What do you mean? I guess the fact that I got the blue garlic bulb and then immediately could use it for something. And then, of course, like, we, unlocked... We'll stop them if, we're running out of time. But, I mean, we're right here. But yeah, like, we just get the blue Pikmin, and now we're in a level that has significantly more water in it than the past one did. So, yeah, Dennis, you seemed a little surprised that I haven't played my Switch since last Thursday. What games have you been keeping busy with on the Switch? I've actually been playing a good amount of Palia offline. And like I said, and I showed, just a silly amount of art lately. Like, positive, but a silly amount of art. And I did see that the Palia event, their first ever event that they're running, just launched earlier today. So I'm going to be streaming that tomorrow. We'll check it out starting at 3 p.m. and then jump into some Core Keeper around 6. Still chipping away at 100% Tears of the Kingdom. Wow, very nice. Yeah, the last time I played Tears of the Kingdom before the Zonai Tipathon stream was back around, like, my birthday. And it's not that I don't like the game, it's just that I kind of needed to step away from the open world aspect of it, I think. Play something a little bit more streamlined so I can feel more accomplished. Because the other thing I could do in Tears of the Kingdom is just blow through and do all the story stuff, and then kind of, like, go back and pick it up, but then I'm afraid I'm not gonna do that. Like, if I rush through it, I'll just be done with it, you know? Orbital communication sphere. Unfloatable boat. Wait, why is the pumpkin a velvety dream drop when the potato was a child of the earth? I don't understand! Also, peep that nice number of yellow Pikmin. Very nice. So this is ultra spicy nectar. With a color like that, it even looks spicy. It is the main ingredient in Ultra Spicy Spray, after all. Want to try a lick? Nice. Why not? If only for quality control purposes. I wouldn't want to provide my rescue officers with a faulty product. Now, let's give it a try. Guess it's pretty spicy. I'm glad I wasn't the one who licked it. But look how fast you're moving. Just think, with this you could get twice the amount of work done in half the time. Perhaps. But I think ingesting this nectar directly poses some significant risks. Yeah, maybe don't lick the random nectar next time. It's probably not the best move. Alright, well, next time we do some Pikmin, we're gonna start on day 10. We're probably going to jump back into the second world. I had the weirdest dream. Well, thank you for that, Shepherd. I had no idea you had the weirdest dream. We have live. I know earlier Chi-Chi said they were going live, but I haven't seen him live yet. I'll show off the art one more time, and Inky is about to make an appearance, so I'm looking for someone to raid in the meantime. We could say hi to Fox, or we could watch some Palia. Inky, don't you want to say hi? Yes, he does. You stay right there, little cat. Surprise! It's Inky. Look at this baby. Don't you want to buy a Souptember shirt and support all of his Soup Witch familiar dreams? I know you do. What a baby. Such a good boy.
Yeah, look up. Yeah. What a baby.
What a baby. Well done, Shay. 10 of each kind of bean, baby. Alright, so first things first, a reminder, we're starting the Ko-fi monthly subscription tiers. And with that, the Sprout tier, $4 a month, you can get 4 exclusive monthly themed stickers and a postcard print. And if you do the Beanlit tier, which is $8 a month, you get to add the physical early bloomers pin. And you also get exclusive access to some polls for future themes. And what we're talking about here is goodies based on baddies. On top of that, we got the maybe? No, I got rid of it. We have the Souptember shirt, which I can drop a link to. We have the Souptember shirt. And we also have some Pikmin-based trading card prints that are available as postcards. You can order them through Ko-fi. And I'm really thrilled with how they turned out. Oh god, I can't even spell Ko-fi anymore. Thank you, Shay! Inky's embarrassed. Alright. Are you guys feeling some Palia, or are you guys feeling some Skyrim? Let me know what you think. Those are the options of who I have at the moment. I'm gonna be playing some Palia after this, but I don't need to stream the event just because I don't know what the event is yet. You are feeling this nap coming on. You know what? That's totally fair. I think that's fair. Let's go watch some Skyrim. Make sure I have the username spelled right. Fox does a lot of Skyrim and also a lot of IRL city touring streams and is a very enjoyable presence. I think you guys are going to have a good time over here. Thank you so much for coming out and for spending some time with me today. I had a ton of fun playing Pikmin and sharing all of the art I've been working on the past week with you. Nerve-wracking and exciting, because usually I am terrible at keeping that kind of a thing a secret. So thanks again for spending so much time with me today. It means a lot. I will see you guys tomorrow at 3 p.m. Eastern for some Palia. We will be starting the Majiri Market event and seeing what it's all about. Until then, keep going and growing, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye-bye!